So here I am in my man cave again with my extra strong reading glasses, and I'd like to talk about the acoustic improvements I made to try and get the sound a little bit better than it is at the moment. Again, I'm recording directly into my iPhone, so there's no external microphone or anything. So the iPhone is just there, so you can judge how far away it is. And this is the natural sound in my room with nothing done. So in my previous videos, I demonstrated 5 different setups to see which one viewers preferred. And I'm just looking at my notes up there. So if I look away, that's what I'm doing. So the first setup was like this, setup A, which is no treatment at all. It's just the room as it is with my iPhone on a stand on my desk. And then I had treatments B, C and D, which were all different. Some more different than others. And then from that video, there were comments which gave me another idea for treatment E. So I did treatment E in a different video. So I'm going to give you a few clips of those so you can listen to them again. I don't have to show a clip of treatment A because this is treatment A already. So I'll just give you an example of that, followed by clips of the other 4 treatments. Okay, treatment A. I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on high o'er vales and hills when all at once I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils, beside the lake beneath the trees, fluttering and dancing in the breeze. This is setup B. So we've got Nitro McLean or McLean. The one thing you could do to make the sound better is to make it mono. I think you should not sum up left and right, but use the left channel only. Okay, most irreverent. Actually, I didn't. I didn't read out the second part of his comment, which is, I really think your solution is going to be $5,000 interconnects. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear.
Gary Duggan Music. Can you get rid of the liveness by recording in an anaerobic chamber? To which my reply was, yes, in a vacuum, no one can hear you scream.
I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on high o'er vales and hills, when all at once I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils, beside the lake beneath the trees, fluttering and dancing in the breeze. Okay, so that's what they all sound like. I'm going to tell you exactly what I did now. So treatment A, looking at my notes again, nothing, just exactly as the room is normally. Treatment B, I got some pillows out of the bedroom and I put the pillows on the bench in front of me. And these are not just any old, there's that noise again. These are not just any old pillows, they're John Lewis pillows. So you can rely on them to be excellent in quality. So in the video, if you watched it, when you saw me ducking down like that, that was me hiding the fact that I was putting the pillows on the bench. I'm really trying not to edit these man cave videos, just go straight through with them. So that's why I did that. So I know it looked a bit funny, but it got the job done. So treatment C, I took the pillows away again and I just used one of the iPhone's microphones. So that was in mono. The iPhone has a microphone on the front, just about here, and it's on the bottom at the other side. So I can't remember which mic I chose, but I chose the one mic that sounded the best. For me, a point source like the human voice is better recorded in mono. And if I wanted the sound of an opera singer or something like that, I'd set up ambience mics to get the reverberation in the room. But the thing is, when you've got a bit of reverberation like this in this room, which doesn't sound too pleasant, then it seems that the stereo, it just lets the listener understand it a little bit better. So although I would by instinct go for mono, in practice, in this situation, I don't feel that it works as well. And I think many of the commenters would agree with me on that. Now, treatment D was the most controversial because this is where my voice was coming out crystal clear. As though I'd taken all the reverberation out of the room completely. Well, this is Adobe Podcast. What this is, it's a free service that Adobe provides. And excuse me, I shall just mute or dim that frog in my throat. It's a free service that Adobe provides to improve podcast audio. And there are a number of aspects to this, but one of these is that you can upload your audio file and it'll improve it in inverted commas like that. And, well, it did make it very clear, but it turned it into some kind of robot voice. It was just completely unnatural, and really I found it rather unpleasant to listen to. I know everyone hates listening to the sound of their own voice, but I hated that even more. Some of the commenters did like it. So, you know, if you like it, you like it. So there's no question of what people's taste is. One person's taste is as valid as another's. But I think the consensus was that it was just too unnatural. How this works, I've tried looking that up, but it seems to be a bit of a mystery. Obviously, this is 2023 and artificial intelligence is going to be involved. I'm just checking that my video is running. Artificial intelligence. So I'm guessing what it's doing is it's taking the recording, it's transcribing the text somehow, it's analysing the voice, and then it's resynthesising the voice according to the text. So I know from my own experience that voice synthesis these days can be amazingly good. So that's not a question that can be done. That's my guess. I don't think they're just removing the reverb. I think they're really almost taking it back to bare bones and giving it back from scratch. But in this instance, I didn't like it. So I'm not saying it wouldn't work for other people in different rooms. I'm just saying in this situation, I didn't like it and I shan't be doing it again. Setup E. This is where I got the idea from people's comments. So as you know, I've got a green screen behind me. And I think it was two people commented that I should replace my green screen with a green carpet. Well, when you think about it, that's the most obvious thing in the world, isn't it? So rather than using green screens, you might as well get some acoustic treatment at the same time. Well, I'm not going to go to the carpet shop and buy a green carpet just for this. So what I did was I got my duvet, I got my winter weight duvet out. It's a double duvet, so it's quite large. And I've got a stand that I used to use for my green screen, so I hung the duvet from that. I have to say, it wasn't a John Lewis duvet, it was an Asda duvet. Don't look like the kind of person that can afford a John Lewis duvet. I think not. Anyway, this was a real struggle to get it on the stand because the stand was made for lightweight material and the duvet really was quite heavy, so I really don't want to have to do that every time I make a video. The whole point of this is that it's easy. I can just set up the iPhone and just do it. So that was completely contrary to that. Now, the funny thing was that I didn't hear very much difference and the commenters didn't hear very much difference either. I expected more of a difference and the difference really was quite minimal. And I think if you listen out for it, you can hear it. I think I'll just go through those examples again so you can correlate what I've just told you with what it sounds like. So, example A, I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on high of vales and hills, when all at once I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils, beside the lake beneath the trees, fluttering and dancing in the breeze. This is setup B, so we've got Nitro McLean, or McLean. The one thing you could do to make the sound better is to make it mono. I think you should not sum up left and right, but use the left channel only. Okay, most irreverent. Actually, I didn't I didn't read out the second part of his comment, which is, I really think your solution is going to be $5,000 interconnects. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear.
Gary Duggan Music. Can you get rid of the liveness by recording in an anaerobic chamber? To which my reply was, yes, in a vacuum, no one can hear you scream.
I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on high of vales and hills, when all at once I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils, beside the lake beneath the trees, fluttering and dancing in the breeze. Okay, so you've had a chance to hear it all again, all of the examples. I think from what I've heard, I prefer setup B. The pillows are a bit bulky, so I might look for a more compact alternative. And I've probably got a couple of acoustic tiles knocking around somewhere that I can spare for it. So I might try that in the meantime, but I will be looking for a more permanent solution, something which is really easy. I can just set up and use like that and will give reasonable sound quality. So that's it for now. I think we've covered that. And of course, you'll have your comments, which just go down there. Just down there in the comments, just making sure that you realise that. OK, I'm just going to say one more thing before I go. I've got the frog again. The one more thing before I go is, did you know that you can like comments. Obviously, you know that you can like videos, but not very many people actually do like comments. So if you see a comment that you like, that you agree with, please like it. What will happen is that the YouTube algorithm will let those comments float to the top. So the people that have made the best, most insightful comments will get read more. Simple as that. So if you see a comment that you agree with, please like it. That's it for today. See you soon.
He's making some of his videos from his man cave now, and we're not allowed in.
Do you have a YouTube?
Yes, I have a YouTube.
Then maybe we should watch The Lockpicking Lawyer.
Link in the description?
Yes, he won't notice.